Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 2.2, Problem 2. This is Section 2.2, Problem 2. It says the data shows the number of times today the 25 random people check their Facebook page. So some people checked 2 times, not at all, etc. A says create a frequency distribution for this data. So a frequency distribution is going to be a chart with 2 columns, one column for the different classes and the other column for the frequencies. So we can label this classes and frequencies, which I'll abbreviate. So some people check their Facebook page not at all during the day. A few people checked it once. And the biggest number was 5. So let's go 2, 3, 4, 5. And now what we want to do is carefully count out how many of those 25 people check their Facebook page 0 times, or not at all. So coming across the top row, there's 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5. There was a frequency of 5 for the number of people who check their Facebook page 0 times in the day. So next class is 1. How many people check their Facebook page once during the day? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are also 5 people who check their Facebook page once in the day. How many people checked it twice? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 people check twice during the day. How about 3 times? 1, 2, 3, 4. There were 4 people in the group that checked Facebook 3 times, frequency of 4. How about 4 times? 1, 2, that seems to be it. And 5 times. It's once here, and a second time here. Now at this point of doing a frequency distribution, it's good to see if your frequencies add up to a total of how many data points you have. So right in the question, it says that there's 25 people, and you can see there's 5 rows of 5, so 5 times 5 is 25. Do my frequencies add up to 25? And again, if they don't, I must have made a mistake. If they do, it's not a guarantee that you did it right. You may have made 2 mistakes where one off balances the other, but let's see what we get. So 5 and 5 is 10. 10 plus 7 is 17. 17 plus 4 is 21. Then 21 and 2 is 23. And 23 plus 2 more, 25. It does add up to 25. So that's good. So that's part A. Frequency distribution. There's our frequency distribution. Chart with 2 columns. First column lists the classes, different types of things that can happen. And the second column lists how many times each one of those happens, the frequencies. So B is create a relative frequency distribution for this data. So it's going to be the same chart with one more column at the end. It's going to have relative frequencies, each frequency over the total, which the total in this case is 25. So frequency, oh no, class first. Class, then frequency, and then relative frequency. And again, I abbreviated a little bit just to make it fit in the columns. Anyway, the first one was the answer of part A, and this one I'm working on next to it is the answer of part B. The first column will be exactly the same, 0 through 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The frequencies will still be the same. 5, 5, 7, 4, 2, 2. So far it's really exactly the same. Here's where the extra part comes in. So the total of all the frequencies when I added them up was a total of 25. So now the first class, people who check 0 times per day for Facebook, would be the frequency of 5 over the total of all the frequencies, which is 25. The second class, people who check Facebook once per day, would be the frequency of 5 over the total of all the frequencies, which is 25. Then the next class, people who check Facebook twice a day, it'd be the frequency for that class, which is 7, over the total of all the frequencies, which is 25. Next, 3 times that people check per day, frequency is 4, over the total of all the frequencies, which is 25. And then the next class had a frequency of 2, so relative frequency will be that 2 over total of all the frequencies, which is 25. And finally, the last class also had a frequency of 2, and the total of all the frequencies is 25. So the fractions, some can be reduced. You can leave them all the same over 25. If you prefer decimals with your calculator, you could do the numerator divide by the denominator equals, and in this case, the calculator would tell you that it's 0.2. Or you can just leave them like that. Those are good. Now the final part, part C, is draw a histogram for the frequency distribution in part A. Just the frequencies, not the relative frequencies. Again, a histogram is a special type of bar graph. The bars must be vertical as opposed to vertical or horizontal. Only vertical for a histogram. And they have to touch, no spaces in between. So I'm going to have 6 bars. The 0 through 5 will be the labels for the bars, the classes. The frequencies will be the heights of the bar. So my biggest bar will go up to a height of 7. I need at least 7 little lines. 1 at a time is a sensible number scale. Again, if my biggest number was, say, 48, I wouldn't want to make 48 little lines. I'd probably go 5 at a time for a biggest bar of 48. But in this case, 7, 1 at a time is a very good number scale. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I can stop there, but since I have room and it doesn't cost me a dime, 8, 9, 10. 10 is a nice place to stop. And you could certainly stop at 7. That would be okay, but 10 makes it look nice. So the first bar has a frequency of 5, so it will have a height of 5. So on my number scale, I have a 5. The bar will go to that height. Again, it's vertical. It has to be vertical for histogram. And it gets labeled with a 0 because that's what class it represents. The class of 0 goes up to a height of 5. Same for the class of 1. Same height, 5. Same height. Again, the bars touch. And the next bar is labeled 1. The next bar, 2, again for people who check Facebook twice in one day, has a frequency of 7, so its bar will go up to a height of 7. And again, the bars touch. It looks like 7's right about there. I'm going to label that with a 2 because that's the class it's representing. And the next one for 3 has a frequency of 4. It'll go up to a height of 4. So I have a 4 on my number scale. It's about there. The bars touch. That's for 3. People who checked Facebook 4 times in a day, frequency was 2, so the height of the next bar will go up to 2. Again, it has to be vertical. It has to touch the previous bar, so that gets labeled 4. And finally, the last one, people who checked Facebook 5 times in one day, the only 2 people that did that. So frequency of 2 means the bar has a height of 2, same height as the previous bar it touches, and it gets labeled with a 5. And that's the histogram.